$1.5 million apartment in New York. The kitchen open and homey.
If I looked in your refrigerator, would I find cookie dough ice cream, hot dogs with cheese and mayo, and pickles?
Uh-huh. We would find all those things. And Pop-Tarts.
And Pop-Tarts?
And Pop-Tarts.
Take the winding stairs to the penthouse terrace and the city sprawls at your feet. She also has a little piece of real estate she picked up back home in Kentwood, Louisiana, population 2,656. She built a $4.5 million house for her mother, who had steered her childhood career. It's called Serenity. Spears also has a brother, Brian, who lives in New York, and a little sister, Jamie Lynn, star of Nickelodeon's All That. And what about Dad? He's a building contractor who chose to stay in the small house where Brittany was raised, just 7 miles away from the mansion her mother loves.
Every day she calls and she's like, I love my house. It's so beautiful. Yeah, that was the coolest thing ever.
But your dad wanted to stay in the old house?
Yes, yeah. They wanted to, they eventually separated, so they have their own lives right now.
Do they have very different views of you and what you should do?
I think they really, at heart, I mean, they love each other so much, but I think sometimes you can love somebody, but they just cannot live together.
It still hurts.
Yeah. Oh.
If you're their child.
Yeah, well, when I was younger, I mean, of course you want your family to be able to, you know, stay together. And who knows what could happen eventually. They may get themselves together and come back and it'd be wonderful, which would be the ideal thing. But right now, you know, this is what needs to happen.
Does your dad have a lot of opinions about what you do?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
I
mean, not like...
disapproving?
Well, some things, yes. Like, baby, okay, what were you wearing? Why did you, you know, of course my dad does that. And my pawpaw, too.
Your grandpa?
Yeah.
Brittany, right here, please.
Her family is still her constant. Her aunt, who's been battling cancer, has also been there for her as a chaperone on the road. What am I to do to win my life? There's help, too, with the money. Her reported net worth, $100 million. Last year, she was rated the number one most powerful celebrity by Forbes magazine.
And we always hear these cautionary stories of people who made
so much money and then they lose their money. So, yeah, and I have an uncle from back at home who takes care of my big sum of money.
Last year, she gave away $1 million to charity, including her own foundation for inner city kids to study music and dance. But the girl whose formal education ended in the 9th grade carries inside her an old fear that it can still all go away. And she'll be back selling crawfish in her grandma's store.
You said once it would be going back to Louisiana and working with crawfish again and having everything disappear.
I probably did at one point, but it's really weird. Like, I enjoy my life and I love what I do, but at the same time, even though we didn't have that much then, I was really happy. Like, I'm looking back right now, just the simplicity of life. Mm. It was very nice.
You're gonna shop in there. The stores are me. Yeah.
Back before she could buy anything she wanted.
It's really weird because I don't think right now I'm really like, I'm not like how I used to be. I mean, I used to roll quarters for freaking clothes, but I mean, I'm not like that. I mean, sometimes I splurge. My assistant, Felicia, she helps me out on that. She was like, if you want it, you just get it. I'm like, okay, I'll get it. But there is something about me, like if there's a sweater for $1,000, I can't buy that. Like, I just, there's something in me that being raised, you know, a certain way, I can't, you know, do that.
You read the stories about buying $100,000 of sportswear.
No, I'm not like that at all. No.
Is it an addiction?
Is it an addiction? No, I don't think so. I think it's an addiction. I think it does put me, like, it makes me happy. You know, I'll go and I'll buy a hat and I'll buy some shoes and, you know, you feel pretty, you feel girly. I love that feeling. So, but no, it's not an addiction. Everything's so, no.
And in a way, it's all part of her job, because her influence on young American fashion is seismic. She buys one new piece of clothing, it can set the whole world talking.
Oh, what was I thinking when I wore that? That's really dreadful. At the time, though, I thought it was, like, the coolest outfit in the world. You know what? I really like that outfit. Oh, and I got to go out with Michael Jackson. Huh. That was cool.
So happy birthday, my friend, the King of Pop.
He's still an idol of yours?
Yeah, I definitely, I mean, I think that he's done, I mean, if you really think of a genius that he is, I mean, he's brilliant. And Billie Jean, all the old stuff that he used to do, I think he's great.
Doesn't he worry you, though? The baby over the balcony kind of Michael Jackson?
Well, I think maybe growing up, like, at such a young age, and it's probably affected him somewhat, and maybe it's kind of, but I think he's a great person at heart, and I just think maybe he needs me to call him. You know, he probably needs some friends around him, to be honest, or, you know.
You think all the stuff written about him is untrue with little kids?
I want to think that's untrue. I choose to believe that's untrue. Yeah.
And what's the picture of you like the best?
The first time I went to the Grammys. It was my first time to go to a huge show, and I had a white dress on. I felt like Marilyn Monroe. It felt really special, so.
Wait a minute. Can you rewind that tape? Am I seeing what I think?
That's probably one of the moments that I really like the best.
You can pop your knuckles?
Britney Spears is popping her knuckles.
How do you do that?
I don't know.
For the Princess of Pop, a year of pain.
You've had a year that would test a lot of people.
Yeah, it was a weird time. Ew, I'm on the first. Can we stop?
When Prime Time continues. But now I know. The most famous 21-year-old on the planet. She's everywhere. Think you know her? Think again.
What happened to your clothes?
Well, I have on clothes now.
Britney Spears and Diane Sawyer setting the record straight.
You've had a rough year. A year that would test a lot of people.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Oh my goodness. Hello. Ew. Yeah, it was a weird.
No holds barred.
Do you like your voice?
I think my voice is okay, but I would love to have a voice like Christina.
Words can't bring me down.
I would love to have a voice like Whitney Houston. I love their voices.
And what about that kiss?
So here's the definitive for the last time ever Madonna kiss, okay?
Okay.
And of course, Justin.
You did something that caused him so much pain, so much suffering. What did you do?
Britney, uncensored.
Can I just say that? I did. Hello.
Tonight, in the zone, with Britney Spears.
Good evening, I'm Diane Sawyer. Charlie's off tonight. And we welcome you to a special edition of Primetime Thursday, as tonight we go exploring. Destination, Britney. Britney Spears, America's most famous paradox in pink. The girl is a steel trap marketer with more than $52 million in albums alone. But she still frightens herself with worst case scenarios and constantly bites her nails to the quick. Especially now that she has a new CD coming out that has to try to build a bridge between Britney past and the Britney to come.
Ladies and gentlemen, the most valuable square inch of real estate in the entertainment universe. This is the girl who owns it, 21-year-old master of the trade.
Now watch me. It's so weird, sometimes I think I'm more comfortable on stage than I am in my own room. When I get on stage, it's kind of like your chance to let go and be something that you're not, maybe. It's your time to dream, and then I look back and I'm like, oh, okay, I just did that, you know.
What's the nightmare scenario right now?
I think I'm a little nervous about my album coming out. Yeah.
Your nails aren't bitten.
Well, that's because I have false nails on right now. Yes.
underneath?
Yes, underneath there.
Yeah. No one would know if we hadn't told absolutely everybody.
Exactly. The whole world knows now.
Right. So the warrior lives?
Yes, the warrior definitely lives. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But they're cute. I did these yesterday. They're just pink.
And Britney Spears is not the only one worrying. She's just the tycoon at the center of Britney Inc., which supports hundreds of dancers, publicists, product designers, marketers, roadies, record executives. Last year, Spears reportedly made $39.2 million. That's about $107,000 per day. So a whole empire can fail if the fans don't follow where she leads.
A lot of people don't make it.
And
they keep writing, you know.
Will I make it?
Her hometown newspaper once asked, will she have the staying power of Madonna or be the first Debbie Gibson of the new millennium?
I guess the test will tell.
Do you like your voice?
Do I like my voice? I'll be completely honest. I think my voice is okay. I like the feeling that I get when I sing. It's not so much my voice. It's a state that I go in when I sing that I really like. But I would love to have a voice like Christina.
Words can't bring me down.
I would love to have a voice like Whitney Houston. In the Zone is probably the one song that really states where I'm at. Doing what I love to do and dancing. And being in the zone.
And to make it to the next stage, she's made her zone racier than ever. For instance, on the new album, a song called Breathe On Me, which she tried to tell me is just about breathing.
I know what it says, but one of us wasn't born yesterday. Do you really think that's all it's talking about?
Well, I think it's supposed to get you in the mood. You know, like certain songs get you in the mood to feel a certain tension or a certain vibe.
And the girl who always played it close to the line on how much skin she showed posed like this for Esquire magazine. Consider the line officially crossed.
What happened to your clothes?
I have on clothes now.
I know. But what's this about? No kidding. What is it about?
What is it about?
Yeah.
It's about doing a beautiful picture.
Is it about shocking people?
About shocking. You know what? I feel comfortable in my skin. I think it's an okay thing to express yourself. I hate to bring this up, but Kate Hudson, she's 22, she's in Sheets. Jennifer Lopez, she poses very provocatively sometimes. Christina Aguilera, what's the big deal when I do it? Like, come on! You know? I don't understand.
I think everybody always thought you had a different relationship to young girls.
Everyone now, they look back and they're like, what happened to your sweet image that you used to be? And I'm like, then when I came out, you thought I was too provocative. It's like you could never win. No matter what you do, at the end of the day, you can't please everybody. You know, I'm not here to please. Ugh.
Have you ever gone further than you wish you had?
Gone further?
Yeah.
No. I don't think so. No. Okay. Now, those are a little much. Yeah, those are a little, much at the end of the shoot. I was like, all right, let's go ahead and do it, and then let's jet. And I didn't have approval over the thing. So that's one picture, I must say, that I felt kind of weird about. Yeah.
Wish you hadn't done it?
A little bit, yeah, to be honest. But hey, it's done, and I'll learn from it, and I'll never be put in that position again.
Getting burned by the fire she lit herself. It's so easy in her business. Her first deal with the publicity devil was made even before she could read. She was a gymnast turned dancer turned contest star. This is rare footage of her singing in a talent competition.
There I said it again.
Age 10, a finalist on Star Search.
Britney Spears.
Oh my God. Oh, and my big bow in my hair. That's so
and
sad.
Belting songs out. One of those big Annie voices.
Yeah, it was very Broadway. Mm-hmm.
Can you still do that?
Wait, I'm trying to think. They say, oh, I don't want to sing it.
Just give me one line. Give me one line.
Okay. They say I'm crazy, got no sins, but I don't care.
They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care.
You see?
Okay, thank you.
By age 11, she's there on the Mickey Mouse Club with another star in waiting, Justin Timberlake.
All I know is that you are mine.
By 15 years old, Spears had signed a major deal with Jive Records, the same fame factory that turned out the number one hits of NSYNC, the Backstreet Boys. So the factory went to work on her, and they had a little song for her to sing. But Spears had a bigger idea, to sing it as a Catholic schoolgirl in knee socks and a tied-up shirt. And now, 6 years later, she's still constantly feeding the publicity monster, as much as she seeks the attention. Does she worry that something's being given away?
I just wonder, at the end of the day, if you ever feel you lose something.
Well, I think right now I'm trying to find the balance of being open and at the same time having stuff for yourself. Like, where I come from the South, and my mom invites people over, the fans outside, for tea. I'm like, Mama, you can't do that, you know? That's how I am at Nate. Like, that's how I am. I'm like an open person. You know, the people around you, they become leeches, so you can't be so open sometimes.
Coming up, a house tour, and we talk about boyfriends and so much more. That's when we return.
And now, boys. You know from the song that Britney Spears is the troubadour of boys of all kind. So you wonder, who are the dream men in her life right now? Well, see if you can guess which photo she keeps in a solitary picture frame in her living room.
I know it's when you're talking about. I'm embarrassed.
I have it here. Ta-dum! The crush continues.
Yes, the crush continues. We shouldn't show that. I'm embarrassed. Okay. That's my little thing.
It's a secret. Inside, she's still a fan.
So who are the dream guys now? Still Brad?
Yes, definitely Brad. And I don't
know.
Ben Affleck, he's cute. And I think Colin Farrell's really cute, too. I think it's refreshing that he doesn't care what people think about him, and he says whatever's on his mind.
Are you still friends with him?
I mean, we talk every once in a while, but he's very busy right now.
Yeah, because I followed the kissing and the tabloids, and are they together, or no, were they just out for a minute?
Oh, no, we're not together. I'm single right now, completely single, so.
Something about the way you say that, completely single.
It's a good thing. I mean, of course you get lonely sometimes, but I like being by myself right now. I think it's good for me.
But Fargo, y'all give me a group hug. Okay?
In some ways, she's like a laboratory experiment in the insulating power of relentless fame. Remember, no high school or college life to practice dating. No anonymity for trial and error and embarrassing choices. After the Farrell frenzy, what she's called a regrettable near fling. With Fred Durst of Limp Bizkit, who raced to the airways to boast.
She's trying to play me out a little bit because she's Britney Spears.
What, is it embarrassment that she slept with you? I mean, what are you, a bad person?
You said recently, I'm not doing so good with relationships.
No, I'm not. It's hard for me to let people in sometimes. Yeah.
And she always seems to be paying for her teenage comments.
You're right, Brittany.
You're left.
We get an interview with her.
See what I go through?
That she was going to stay a virgin until marriage.
I would love to be able to try and wait till marriage.
And that she didn't even drink. In the past year, a report that she had tried serious drugs at a club. We asked, starting with marijuana.
I've been around people and I've gotten the high off of it, and that is enough for me. I can't. Do that. I don't do that.
You talked about experimenting, partying. Cocaine?
No, I never.
They left the impression that at clubs that you tried cocaine.
I've experimented in partying, but never that. I could never do something like that. I mean, I definitely, in this industry, there's people that are around you 24/7. So you know, you just have to learn who you hang out with. And I mean, I've had amaretto sours, and if I'm gonna drink, and I love red wine right now. Red wine, it makes me like really mellow, and I like. But as far as I'm such a control freak, I would never be able to do something that makes me feel out of. I mean, drinking makes me feel that way sometimes, so I can't.
And maybe she has another kind of adolescent rebellion. London, insulting fans by showing up late to her movie premiere, no autographs, barely saying hello. In Mexico City, 4 months later, a finger for the paparazzi. And then, five songs into her concert, the last night of her world tour, she walked off stage in front of 50,000 fans.
It's too dangerous a situation, okay?
It was raining, and she says it was dangerous.
We're going to go out there, and we're going to do the first two songs, or whatever. Like, if it starts to clear up, but if it starts raining again, and if it's bad, then I'll just stop in the middle of the show.
And indeed, a documentary shows she and her tour manager are agonizing over what to do backstage.
It's all irrelevant. With it coming down right there, nobody's going on.
But out front, the crowd turned and started yelling, "Fraud! Fraud!" And it all happens as she's starring as a kind of villain in the tabloid accounts of supposed jealous arguments and then a horrible breakup with her self-proclaimed first love, Justin Timberlake.
You've had a rough year. You've had a year that would test a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Illness in the family.
Mm-hmm.
A breakup. This spasm of publicity about what happened in from Mexico to London.
It was pretty rough, yeah. Yeah, it's kind of weird. Ah, weird. Hello. Oh my goodness, hello. Ew, strong Britney. Yeah, it was a weird time. Ew, I'm embarrassed, can we?
The breakup with Justin. Did he sell her out on a music video? Britney's side of the single.
He's left the impression that you weren't faithful, that you betrayed the relationship. I had the
when Prime Time returns. Breaking up with Justin. He has his song. She has hers. Who's telling the truth?
My weakness caused your pain and your song of sorrow. Who's that for?
Who's that for? Oh, goodness. Goodness, goodness.
After this, from our ABC stations.
I'm not a girl.
Once again, Diane Sawyer.
You have to keep reminding yourself that Britney Spears is only 21 and everything in her life so far has been laid out in public. First guy, first time, and first lesson learned in the bruising business of breaking up.
It's another one of the songs on her new CD. It's called Every Time. She wrote it. Listen to the words. My weakness caused you pain, and this song's my sorry.
Who's that for?
Who's that for? Oh, goodness. Goodness, goodness. I'll let the song just speak for itself.
Okay, you can bop me. I have to ask a couple of things about Justin.
Okay, of course.
He has gone on television and pretty much said, you broke his heart. You did something that caused him so much pain, so much suffering. What did you do?
I was upset. I was upset for a while. We both I think we're both really young, and it was kind of waiting to happen. And I will always love him. He'll always have a special place in my heart. He is such a great person.
But you said, I've only slept with one person in my whole life, 2 years into my relationship with Justin. And yet he's left the impression that you weren't faithful, that you betrayed the relationship.
I think everyone has a side to their story. And to make them feel a certain way, make them feel, you know. And I'm not technically saying he's wrong, but I'm not technically saying he's right either. So, this feels really awkward right now.
Timberlake has made a kind of sport out of public retaliation. On a popular morning drive radio show in New York promoting his album, he has a kind of gleeful confession about their very private life.
Hot 97. The Star of Buckwell Morning Show. Justin Timberlake is in the house. And I just want to ask you one question. Did you Britney Spears? Yes or no?
Oh, man.
Come on, man. Okay, I did it. No,
yeah! It was a really weird time. There was, like, talk about our... what we did together and like really
sexually
and stuff, and I just felt very exploitive and very weird. I was like, why is he going on these shows and they're asking him and he's talking, you know? But I'm sure, like, you know, just like right now, you're asking me about it and I'm talking about it and it just kind of comes out.
And there's more. She says Timberlake called her ostensibly to catch up, but then slipped in the fact that her look-alike would be starring in his new video, Cry Me a River. She says she couldn't think fast enough to object. And was stunned to see a kind of recreation of their breakup.
When did you see it for the first time, the video?
I saw it. I was on vacation, and someone called me and told me that it was going to come on, and I watched it, and I was just like, I was kind of in denial. Like, I went in this whole denial phase or whatever, but it's fine. That's the way he, I don't want to judge him or anything like that, because that's the way he had to deal with what happened, and, you know, and that's fine, but I know that if I was in a relationship and something happened, I couldn't really go there, but it's all good. Let's talk about something else.
The call he made about Cry Me a River, what lesson do you learn from that?
I guess to really look out for yourself. Just to look out for yourself.
If you were talking to your little sister now, and the girl who said that she was going to stay a virgin till she got married, do you still think there's something to be said for that?
I think, honestly, if you can wait till you're married, I think you should definitely do that, because it's so much more sacred. And there is a reason for saying to do that. There is a rule in the book, the Bible, that says that. I think that is a really important thing to do. But I think in reality, if you really know in your hearts of heart that you are going to be with that person forever, and you really think that with all of your heart, and you're in 4 or 5 years into the relationship, I mean, stuff can happen. You know, I mean, you don't go around sleeping around with people, but I mean, I really thought that I was going to be with him for the rest of my life. I did. And, but telling my sister, I would, you know, I can just give her unconditional love and just trust her. I think when you doubt people and they're going to do the wrong thing, if you're too preachy with them, that's when they run and they rebel. I trust that she'll do the right thing. She's a good girl, and she's a very smart girl. She has good instincts about people, so.
How soon? 5 years? Would you like to have a guy?
That would be the ultimate dream. Yeah. That would be great.
Are you thinking you'll wait till you're 30?
I don't want to wait till 40. I'm 30. No, no. I would love to have a family. That would be when I'm the most content. My kids and just, I mean, that's, they become your life. It's not all about you anymore, and you have a focus that's so beautiful. I'm not a girl.
Not yet a woman? A woman.
Yeah, I feel like I'm a lot older than what I feel wise. I don't know. I feel from 5 years ago, definitely. I'm
making music to making out with Madonna. How far is too far?
When you have all those lights, you really let go, and we really did it.
When Primetime continues.
With Madonna as her model, Britney Spears has upset a lot of mothers in this country, starting with the wife of the governor of Maryland, who appeared at an anti-violence rally, and well, listen to what she said.
Really, if I had an opportunity to shoot Britney Spears, I think I would.
Oh, that's horrible. Well, that's really bad.
Because of the example for kids and how hard it is to be a parent and keep all of this away from your kids.
Well, that's really sad that she said that. Ew. You know what? Like, I'm not here to, you know, babysit her kids.
Later, the governor's wife had to retract her statement because of a public outcry about her reference to guns. But it is true that kids made Britney Spears, and then she remade them in her image.
We love Britney!
Oh, baby, baby, how was I supposed to know?
And then, in the past 2 years, that image has taken a highly explicit turn as she searched for a new edge. We wondered, does she care what her old fans, those kids, think, for instance, about this?
How could it hurt you when it looks so good?
So here's the definitive for the last time ever Madonna kiss, okay? So she said that she had this idea for a little peck, and then you gave her a real kiss. Is this the way it happened?
Well, yes, it was her idea. We were in rehearsals, and she's like, well, maybe we should kiss. And I'm like, okay, all right. And we never really did it in rehearsal. When we actually got on stage and we did it, it's like when you have all those lights, you really let go, and we really did it.
You said there's no tongue action here.
Oh, of course there was no tongue.
Well,
oh,
it looked like it. It looked like there was.
Well, that's, you know, we're good actresses here. Yeah, you know what we're doing. Okay. I can see how you say that, because if our mouths were a little open like that, and right, it looked like, but
I mean, I know those two ladies don't really give a damn what I say, but I think it's irresponsible in a way.
Bette Midler, who used to push a few envelopes herself.
It's kind of tacky in a way, because to say that I'm not responsible for the fact that there's, you know, 10, 11-year-olds watching this show.
I mean, I'm, you know, I can't help that, and if the parents don't like them to see it, then change the channel. So, sorry, you know, I'm not perfect. I make mistakes every day, honey. I know, but I want to be a good person for me, but I think it's a huge pressure to think that you have to take the responsibility to be this role model.
It's one thing not to want to be the role model anymore. It's another thing. Young girls are looking at this. A lot of them.
But am I responsible for them? The only person I do worry about and that I want to be a good person for, I think, is my responsibility, is my sister.
All right, I'm going to be cool for you, okay?
I mean, did you say something to her about the Madonna thing? Is it a lesbian chic thing?
Beforehand, I did call her and say, look, I'm doing a performance, and I'm going to be, you know, kissing Madonna. But she thinks of it as, you know, as a performance. She doesn't take it literally.
Okay. It's classic Britney, as a magazine said, a kind of puzzle under all those shifting images, playing innocent, and then playing the shock for all it's worth. But is this as far as you're going to go?
Hmm?
Because I remember reading once you said, I'm not going to do that Madonna thing and try to shock everybody.
Never say never, huh? Textbook and stuff like that. I didn't think that would be something that I wouldn't go towards, but like I said, never say never. Karma's gonna bite me in the ass.
With that, she volunteers to me that I don't even know about another song on the new album. A song about, well, I think I'll let her tell you.
I have one song. It's called Touch of My Hand. That's talking about you with yourself, which is a little much. But it's a reality that we have, and
Yeah, okay.
The small of my back, the arch of my feet, the lady of the notice and the beautiful me.
But I mean, you get to have it both ways. So you know, I'm not that innocent. Mm-hmm. Or are you that innocent?
I think we all have sides to us. I think that, yes, I can relate to that song, and like we all can. You'd be lying if you said you couldn't, but there is a, I mean, it's not something you openly talk about with a lot of people. It's something sacred, and it's something I wanted to write about, so.
Sacred?
No, the song, Touch of My Hand, talking about indulging in yourself.
And that's sacred?
It is sacred to me, but in a way, exploiting it. Okay, I'm confusing myself right now.
I'm just going to lean back here and just...
Okay, what's the question again? Go ahead.
I don't remember the question.
I don't either. Okay.
Millions have seen it, but she doesn't like it.
You don't like the famous bottom? The world famous?
The world famous bottom? Ew, don't say that.
When Prime Time continues.
And so, Britney Spears' new album is getting ready to hit the stands. And Britney Spears, the entertainment athlete, is about to go into her own Olympic training to hit the stage. Even the critics of Spears' singing stand in awe of the entertainment machine, the spectacle, the precision dancing. Remember, as a child, she was actually training to be an Olympic gymnast when lured away by the stage. And she can keep up with the best of them. The Jacksons, Michael and Janet. NSYNC and the drill team boy bands. And some stars wouldn't dare try to keep up with their dazzling professional backup dancers. But Spears is right there matching them move for move. She's been rumored to stay in shape by doing hundreds of sit-ups a day.
I don't feel completely like the best shape right now, you know, but I'm not really self-conscious about it. I know that I can better myself and be in better shape.
And your the famous abs?
The famous abs. Mm.
You're not working them all the time?
Once I start tour, I'll start, you know, doing that.
And then will she have the perfect body? Not to her.
And you don't like the famous bottom? The world famous?
The world famous bottom? Ew, don't say that. That's a very nice compliment. But I have my brother to always put me in check with that. He's like 24/7. He's like, Brittany, you know, you need to lose some weight.
And there's that other critic, the one from the health police.
Hey, Brittany, you say you want to lose control. Over here, but I got something to show ya.
Madonna is gonna get used to stop smoking. And you ask Britney not to smoke? You lecture her about not smoking?
Yeah. I pretty much lecture everybody that has a cigarette hanging out of their mouth not to smoke.
Okay, this thing. I am cutting back. I have a tour to do. And I'm cutting back on the smoking because there's no way in hell I can be on stage and perform the way I want to.
She said to me, she's watching.
Oh, I know.
Sort of hands on hip.
I know she's watching. She's totally watching.
She scares me.
She really scares me, too. I'm like, okay.
Thanks, babe.
She's a funny lady. I love her, though. She's a great lady.
And it will take a lot of aerobic stamina to dance her way through big numbers like Me Against the Music. She's doing it here on Saturday Night Live. But this performance had everyone raising an old accusation. Was she lip-syncing to recordings? She said she was singing live, but admits there was help.
Sometimes
when you're on stage and you're performing, there's a combined mix with you and the track. And there are parts of the song where you really let go and you do sing, but there are the background vocals. That's basically the track during the courses, right, to help you out, if you call that track. But that's not really technically lip syncing.
Because your voice is not on that.
No, my voice is on that, but it's the background singers helping me. And I think that's what makes people think that it's lip syncing.
But she was clearly out there all on her own in another Saturday Night Live memorable moment. She proved herself a natural comedian, playing a hilarious girl from the hood.
I mean, I told her to step off, and she was like, what?
And I was like, no, you don't. And she was like, huh? And I was like, uh-uh.
So tonight, the global industry that is Britney is poised on the brink of the next. Her video with Madonna is already the most requested video on MTV's Total Request Live. But she's talking about more movies, TV shows, and how she wants to dance her way through another decade.
Can you see the rest of your career?
The ultimate dream, I would love to be able to reinvent myself, do more albums, do musicals.
You only wonder if a girl whose life has been show business can also have a life of her own.
People like Faith Hill and Madonna, they give me hope. The fact that they have their families with them and they can balance the whole thing, and, you know, I think that's inspiring, so.
You've said that your albums are like diaries of your life. So what's the lead sentence? How would you start the diary entry for your life right now?
The diary entry for my life. Whoa, I'm here to inspire people through my music and take people on journeys and let them feel stuff. Really, I feel like I'm just beginning, and all this change and everything is like kind of surreal and new, and so it feels like a beginning for me.